ones that are already getting that, it wouldn't be God.
Yeah.
I'm trying to take you to a place that you've never been before. And you, hallelujah, will be like an astronaut. You'll be going beyond. Hallelujah. Yes. Don't see, you can see right now. But I want you to even apply it to your personal life.
That's right.
What are you looking for God?
Thank you, Lord.
Worldwide, what you looking for? What you looking for? What you looking for God? Yes. Believe it, hallelujah. Because he said it. Every promise, hallelujah. Every promise of God, hallelujah. Yes. Yeah and amen. Yes. You can have it if you believe it. If your faith would take you there without doubting it. Even if you want deliverance.
Amen.
You can be self-delivered.
Yes.
If your faith will come up to where it needs to be.
Yes. Glory to God.
Your relationship with God has to come up to the level where it is.
Yes. Glory to God.
Romans 4:20 says, he staggered not at the promises of God through unbelief, but was strong in faith, giving glory to God. In your faith, you got to be able to give glory to God, not to yourself, not to anyone else, not to the new mayor, not to the new president, but to God.
Amen.
To God. To God. Amen. Yes, Lord.
Amen. Amen.
We keep looking at what we have accomplished.
Mm.
Yep. We have not accomplished anything without God.
Right.
Because if God had not woke you up this morning, you would not even be here right now. If God hadn't gave you the energy to go to that little job where you're playing that, putting your faithful 8 hours a day, hallelujah, that you will not miss a day, because I will not use my sick leave. I will be, hallelujah, I'll give my big plaque that said I never missed a day. But you want to give yourself glory when God was the one who kept you in good health, hallelujah, who brought you to that job, who gave you that job.
Thank you. Yes, Lord.
As you're traveling down the road, hallelujah, when you're going from one place to another, hallelujah, who you think keeps you, hallelujah, when that accident didn't happen because you made a left turn, because somebody said something within me said make a right right here, hallelujah, and you want to look around and say what?
Yes.
And then you go ahead and make that right, and there it is, a big accident happened. See, we don't want to give God credit for nothing.
All right. Come on.
The activity that he's doing right now in your life.
Yes.
It's only by God that you're even standing, sitting right here in the midst of it. You're even breathing because.
Yes. Hallelujah, Jesus.
Oh, but you take it for granted, right? You're going to wake up tomorrow. Yeah. I know. Tomorrow you'll be able to just praise him just because you woke up, you woke up all good looking, getting ready to put your makeup on and put your, get your hair right. I don't have much to worry about. But as you're getting yourself together, and you didn't even say thank you, Lord, for waking me up this morning.
Oh, yes, Lord.
See, because there were some people that just had a little bit of faith. But when God told Peter to come on out there, he didn't just sit in the boat like some of them.
That's right.
We got too many boat sitters that won't sit in the boat.
Lord.
And watch the man of God go forth in his faith.
Because
ain't nobody supposed to walk on water but the man,
of God. Yeah.
Put all that faith in him, as soon as he makes one mistake,
you're
going to write him off. Hallelujah. You're going to lock the church doors and you won't let him back in. But God forbid that your faith doesn't come up to the level where you just don't sit in the boat anymore. That if you can see God coming toward you, hallelujah. Yeah. If you can see God in your life, hallelujah, you begin to take steps toward him, hallelujah. Yeah. Believing that if you can't even see him, I'm believing that he's there.
Yeah. Hallelujah.
Yeah. For I come this far by faith, hallelujah. Yeah. I'm continuing to keep my eyes on God. But we can be some water walking saints, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
We're going to walk on the water right on over to 8765.
Woo!
The ones who got faith, hallelujah.
Yeah.
The ones that's down right now, they're gonna be the ones coming back saying, hey, I wish I had a stable job. That's the boat sitters.
Yeah.
You sat in the boat and said, Peter, you must be crazy. You must be crazy to get out there and walk on water. Hallelujah. Can't nobody do that but God.
Hallelujah.
But if God be in me, hallelujah, why I can't walk on water too? If God be in me, hallelujah, why can't have some of the things the other folks have.
Yeah, yeah.
This is laid up for us anyway. Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah.
Come on,
Pastor. Go ahead, refinish. that for me, please.
Hallelujah. Verse 6. But without faith, it's impossible to please him.
Okay, go ahead.
For he that cometh to God must believe that he is, and that he is a rewarder of them that diligently seek him.
Woo! I don't know about y'all, but I like that point right there. He is a rewarder of them that
diligently.
And what does diligently mean? On Monday, on Tuesday, on Wednesday. When you're sick, when you're sick, right? When you don't feel good, right? That's when you get real diligent, right?
Come on now.
When you need some help, you get real diligent at seeking God. Because when all the problems of life come to people's life, who's the first name they call?
Jesus.
Oh, Jesus.
Yeah.
Huh. And this was has become the demise of Christianity.
Yes. Mm.
Because they didn't have the faith to believe that God can do it anyway. But they just know that when they get in trouble, and thank God for a merciful, long-suffering God who would send help anyway. Even though I didn't do what you told me to do, God, he still sent somebody along the way. Hallelujah. Even if I didn't even live right, God, he still...
Wow.
Say, what manner is love of this that a man would lay down his life? Hallelujah.
Yes.
What manner is this? We serve a God who laid down his life, hallelujah, just for you, hallelujah. Yes. And look how you've been acting, hallelujah. Look how you've been carrying yourself, hallelujah, saying you're a Christian. We've come this far.
Come on, come on.
Leaning on. Go ahead and finish that, Mom.
Verse 7. By faith, Noah, being warned of God of things not seen as yet, moved with fear, prepared an ark to... This is too good.
That's all right.
Go ahead on. Come on, baby.
Prepared an ark to the saving of his house by the which he condemned the world and became heir of the righteousness which is by faith.
Righteousness even comes by faith.
Mm-hmm.
You have to believe it. If any man be in Christ, he is what?
A new creature.
Keep breathing. The righteousness of God through Jesus Christ, he's already given us that. See, can we stop right there? But this is what the enemy wants you to think, that you're unrighteous. You don't deserve it. But through Christ, I deserve it all. Because he did it all just for me. You have to make it personal. He did it for me. Hallelujah. If you want to have a greater relationship with God, you got to look at it personal. He did it for me. Hallelujah. He did it so that all of us can be here today. Hallelujah. What type of God would send his only begotten son? Would you send your only son? Your only good-looking son who played football, who was all built, and who was the all-star on the team. Would you send him, hallelujah, to die, hallelujah, for some people who didn't look so good, who didn't look so good, you know? You'd be like, not my handsome son. I ain't sending him down there amongst them heathens. You see, we would come up with all kinds of excuses. But God looked down on a dirty nation, hallelujah, of people, hallelujah, who was already confused, hallelujah, because they hadn't followed what he said in the first place. The reason we have the New Testament is because of what you did in the Old Testament.